well, I'm sure it's not too late. Try to pick one up. It's not too early to get that Christmas present, that Hanukkah present, that birthday present, that stuffing stocker, you know, just stock the stuffing and fill it up. But it's really a pleasure once again to have Elio here. He is, as I said, he's been really important to Philadelphia, really important to New York City, really important to the world, obviously extremely important to Cuba as well. But we're very fortunate to have him here tonight. So please put your hands together once again for Elio Villafranca.
All right, we're having a great time up here. I don't know about you, but we're... So now we're gonna start with a piece that is actually featured on my latest album. This piece is entitled Trouble. This piece is entitled Trouble Waters. And it's inspired by the story of Cinque. You guys know about Cinque? No? No? Okay. All right. So actually, it's a very important story to for you guys to know and to tell, because actually, the story of Cinque is one of those stories that unify Africa, the U.S., and Cuba, and then creates like a full circle. And the reason why is because Cinque was an African man who was born in Sierra Leone, and then he was captured and was brought to Cuba to be sold as a slave. The time that he was captured was the time where the U.S. has signed the treaty with Great Britain to abolish the slave trade. Slavery was still available, was still legal, but the trade was illegal. But then still, since Cuba was dependent on the labor, they still continue transporting African to Cuba to, you know, to work on the field. Cinque was one of those guys. So he got to Cuba after many months of travels. Then he was sold, and then in Havana, and then when he was sent to a different region in the east of the island, he revolted over the ship. And you probably heard the story of the ship La Amistad. And then he revolted over that ship, and then he seized control of the ship, and then he ordered them to send them back to Africa. But at night, the crew member, they steered the ship north, and then he was captured here in America, near Connecticut, and then he was took to, they were taken to Connecticut, and then he was trialed there, and then he joined with some lawyers at the time. I think Adams was the ex-president of the Republic at the time, but he became an abolitionist, and then he defended his case, and he gained his freedom, and then he returned to Africa. Now, the reason why I was striking about that story was because at that time, when a black man, especially from Africa, were not even considered a man or a human being, were treated as something like, I don't know what, for him to be able to fight and get the freedom back in the system where, you know, where it was completely supporting slavery and all of that, that was striking. And I can see any story. If that story were to happen today, I don't think that man would be free. So, and then I was inspired by that story to write Trouble Waters. And Trouble Waters is just basically just the time when he revolted over the chip. That's what I was trying to do in Trouble Waters. Okay, enjoy.
Thank you.
Thank you. Charles Gold on drums. Charles Gold. Vincent Henry on alto saxophone. Peter Slav on bass. I don't know. I don't want to hold you here too much. I don't know how long can we play here, but I have a bunch of all the music. But I think maybe Chris Lovett. Lovett? Huh? One more? All right. Okay. So then I'm going to play something that is from this particular town, from a composer, a great composer and guitar musician from this town. His name is Pat Martino. I had the fortune when I was living in Philadelphia. He was one of my heroes, and I got to tour with him and get to play with him and actually get to record with him. And I remember when I met him, I met him at Cruise Jazz Cafe in one of those nights. And then I heard one of his tune, and it has like a funny title, El Hombre. I was like, wait, that's Spanish? And I was very interested, but then I started hearing the music. I was like, wow, I like this tune, but I want to do a version, like in my own version. And then I talked to Pat and said, hey, you know, I love this tune. Can I record it in my very first album that I was already preparing? He was like, yeah, sure. Well, let me just, his voice. Yeah, sure, man. You can. And then he gave me the tune, and then I was like, well, this is your tune. Do you want to play on it? He's like, yeah, sure, I'm playing on it too. Good. So then we did my first album entitled Incantation, Encantaciones, and we recorded El Hombre, and we're gonna play for you the version that we did, El Hombre.
Thank you.
Thank you so much, Vincent Herring, Charles Gold, Peter Slavo. Thank you.